Hello and welcome to another review with the Dino Lord, where today we are reviewing another Lego Star Wars set. Now the poll thing still going if you want to, you know, vote on a new review. But I want to get this one over and done with because this is a set which I've been wanting to do and I forgot to do it last time. So whilst I've done a Star Wars, I'll continue with the theme of Star Wars. So right here we got the TIE Fighter, but that's the build, so we're doing that last. And we got these four minifigures right here. My camera just gone the way, let me move it back. These four minifigures right here still didn't work. There we go. Perfection, I am still getting used to this. So let's go over the minifigures. So the first minifigure, what we're going to go over, is this guy here, which I don't have the box, so I don't know the name. Let's just call him Jimbo. I know that not his name, it just, you know. So this guy here, pretty nice. The head isn't unique. In fact, that head came in quite a bit now. You had this face, and you also had this face, so if I can get it close enough to the camera and zoom in on it, yes, it works this time. Yeah, it's a pretty nice head. I think it's an okay head. I had this one already, so I'm not too special, but it's really nice. The body, love it. Actually, I love the green, like the green on it, the two shade of green. Actually, it looks like a pretty nice detail, and then I think it's silver, right? Does the lighting pick this up? Let me check. Woo. Yeah, silver. Yeah, I think the silver works pretty well. In fact, let me just angle the light a bit more. That things work a bit better. There we go. The hairpiece, you can go over there, is really good. Double molded. You have this colour and this colour. It double molded. Oh, wait, one colour, but it's painted over. I don't know. But either way, it is such a good hairpiece. I love it. Not going to use it on much other characters, but if it ever comes up, I will use it because it is really nice and unique. Let me just find the figure. Here he is. Can't talk today. I am not good at English. So that's the first minifigure. Now onto the second. The next figure is the droid of the set. This guy right here. I forgot his name as well because I'm amazing. Really nice. I like this piece here. The helmet looks really good. I like it. Don't know why I like to talk very loud. I don't know why I'm weird. Anyway, I actually think it's really nice, but that's just a helmet. I have plenty of them. Let go on this guy. Good printing. I think the taller droid legs doesn't work. In fact, I think I built it up wrong or something because it doesn't look right. It looks a bit too, I don't know. I don't think I built it up correct. It looks a bit odd. I don't know. Let me just put it next to the figure. Doesn't look, I don't know, I don't see it correctly, I don't know why. Oh well. That because the middle leg, the leg thing there is missing. Yeah, there meant to be a piece there for a third leg, but I kind of forgot to add that on, so yeah, now I look like a tall droid. Quality, but anyway. This guy, there's nothing much to say, it's just a droid. Worse than R2-D2, but meant to be an R2-D2. But it not, it's weird, this is a weird droid. I'm not a big fan of this one, that's probably the worst part of the set. Anyway, now onto the next figure. The next figure is the General Leia. Now, I like this one. The blaster isn't much, in fact they all have the same blaster. But I think it's the same one as in the 2016 set, except with a different head. I like this. I never bought that set, so I'm happy to have one now. This goes well in my collection. In fact, I'm just missing Old Man Han Solo, and then I got all the older characters, I think. And possibly, no, Hollander as well. You know what? Never mind. I'm stupid. The alternate head is actually really good as well. Mild, but looks evil. Why do they look evil? That doesn't make sense, but who cares? It's Lego, so Lego can get away with whatever they like to do. Including make Princess Leia a villain. Okay, I'm going to do that as a stop motion or something now, because that is a good idea. Anyway. Yeah, not, I like the purple as well. That's really nice, the purple. Getting the lighting a bit better. I really do like this character. Anyway, onto the final figure before we get onto the set. And the final figure is this guy here. Major Vonreg, which is the name of the set. Major Vonreg's TIE Fighter, I think it is. But it's a TIE Interceptor, so anyway, yeah, but you know, let go over this guy. He does have a plain black head, but I'm using the Pixel one meanwhile, because I'm using the plain black one on Godzilla. There we go, plain black head. That's a close-up we're gonna get today. His helmet, I love it. Such a good helmet, like, the angles, the detail. This black part, I think, look really nice on it. There's so much good detail to it. And then the body print and the leg print is so good. I like the dark red hands as well. That just makes a figure which is already perfect even better. But this guy is possibly one of the best Godzilla set. I'm the best Godzilla set. That doesn't make any sense. This figure is one of the best of the set and is the best of the set. Doesn't make any sense. But you know, I'm a noob, so what do you expect from a noob? And now onto the set itself. Actually, the set is really nice. The middle part here, the cockpit, really good. You have this piece here. I just lift the camera up so you can see it. Not getting too much of the way. I like this. It is really nice. Still getting used to the angling and stuff like that still. It is really good. I like this print. It is the same one in the other TIE Fighter, if I'm correct. So not exclusive, but it is to TIE Fighters, I think. Really nice. Inside, look really nice. And if you want to get into the inside, you can lift that up. Really nice, actually. Right, yeah, you have the gun on the side there. In fact, let me pick up the minifigure right here. I'll show you how you get him in there. You sit him down like so. Like so. Sit down in there correctly. There we go. Really easy to get him in there. Except sometimes it pops out because the nail stud holding him in place. And close. Yeah, that's also another issue. It is very odd here, so it does fall down really easily. But not too big of an issue if you're just displaying it and swooshing around it. Close that and close this. And there you go. This wing, the wings are all the same near enough. They are really nice. I like the detail. So much detail on that there. Love it. These don't fire, but that meant to be where it fired from. As well as here. These are actually the guns on there. These actually, you can angle them if you want, but I wouldn't recommend angling. Same on this side. On the roof, you have a nice print. No stickers in this set. If you hate stickers, buy this. Very nice. You also have this lever here for stud shooters. You look here and have some. Here, the stud shooter. So yeah, so it pretty much just, you knock this here. Like boop-a-doop-a-doo. And it fires it forward from there. So it's really nice. Now, final thoughts of the set. Let me put this down back here. Is it a set which I recommend buying? Depends. Do you like TIE Fighters? Yes. If you do, buy it. If you're not too big of a TIE Fighter fan, I would pass on it. I would say, if you do see the 20... Give me a second, I dropped the helmet of a character. Oh. Now I can't find it. Who cares? Anyway. Yeah, if you don't have the TIE Fighter from 2018, I think it is. In fact, let me get that. Right. Okay, I don't think I have enough room here, but I'll show you that just for a bit comparison to right here. It is a lot more taller than the other one, if you can see that right there. Like, and not really a comparison, really, except they're both similar prices, which doesn't make much sense. I really do prefer this grey one. The TIE Fighter itself is a lot better, but if you do see that, buy that. I'm going to do a review on that separately, so be in tune for that. Next up, is this set an offer would be worth it? Buy it on offer. See on offer, buy it. £45 I would say is a good price for it. £65 is really expensive. I bought it at that price, and when I was building it, I was there going, geez, is it nearly done already? It only took me like an hour or so to build it. Not that fast, or well, not that long. It really is a quick build. You can rush through it easily. Not complex. Really rushable. But it is still a really good set, and I do recommend it. Now, The next video won't be a LEGO review, it'll be something different. Maybe not even LEGO like. Might be completely different, so the next video may not be a LEGO review. Say may not because I'm good at changing my mind. If it is, then yee. So yeah. Hope you enjoyed that video. This is possibly one of the worst ones I made so far, because I needed a drink. In fact, I got a tea right here, let me have that. Give me a second. Tea warm. Anyway, yeah, so the next review may be the Clockwork Manor, which I keep on saying in the next review and keep on forgetting. Or this Hidden Side Boss, or the Hidden Side School, or an Overwatch set. Could be one. In fact, never mind about all that. The next review will possibly be this one here, which is the 2007 General Grievous Starfighter, except I lost the pieces at the back, so it's a bit more odd. And it doesn't stand as well, but that could be the next review. If not, it'll be one of the ones which is on the poll. Anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this. Like, comment, and subscribe as always. And yeah, have a nice time, I remember. I'm the Dino Lord, and yeah, nothing else to say. See you next time. Yee.